Okay, folks, obviously this is a GoPro Hero 3 Plus. I bought this when it first came out years ago. This is the only GoPro I've ever had. It's served me just incredibly well. I've not had any issues out of it whatsoever. I've used it on my motorcycle, on rides. I've used it, you know, diving, snorkeling, vlogging, just all sorts of different ways I've used this thing, and it's just worked flawlessly. I've not had not one hiccup with it, not one concern with it. So you might ask, well, what's the problem? Well, really there's no problem. I just wanted to step up to a newer technology, something that offers 4K image stabilization, you know, some features that this camera just simply doesn't have. So I've looked at reviews online, I've read reviews, I've burned YouTube up watching, you know, video reviews, and to all of you out there that do them, thank you very much. They've been very informative, but I am just so tired of looking at reviews, reading reviews on the GoPro 5 versus the 6 and the pros and cons, and you know, I guess either one of those cameras would be a huge step up from this Hero 3 Plus. So it would be, I think, hard for me to go wrong as far as the video capture and features that the camera would have. So I finally, after, I don't know, gosh, I've probably been looking for about 3 months, decided to go with the Hero 6 Black. So why did I go with the 6 over the 5? Well, that's a great question. I'm glad you asked. I just don't know. I do like the image stabilization feature. All of the video comparisons between video capture on the 5 versus the 6, I personally like the image quality that I saw in the 6 over the 5. So I guess if there were reasons I went with the 6, those would probably be the two larger of the reasons why. So, but like I said before, whether I would have gone with the 5 or the 6, I think either one would have been great over what the Hero 3 Plus offers. I mean, this camera, it's great. I have no complaints on its performance, on what it was built to do, what it's capable of doing. But I wanted something with 4K. That's another thing. This is 4K 60 frames per second, so I like that. I like on the newer GoPros where they're waterproof down to 33 feet versus this one you have to use the case in. Now, I'm going to get a case for this one because I'm a little paranoid, and if I go more than, say, 20 or 25 feet deep, I'll probably put it in a case. I just don't want to tempt fate any more than necessary. So I've got to order a case for it. I want to get the red tinted lens, and this one's got a little aftermarket doohickey here that, you know, attaches to the front, and you just slide, you know, your lens down in here. And for those of you that have never used an underwater red tinted lens for you know, blue water, man, they're really worth it. It improves the image quality so much. So if you're on the fence in that regard, you know, take the plunge, get a red lens. So I do diving, snorkeling. I'm going to the Virgin Islands in September, so I'll definitely be using it for the diving and snorkeling I do there. So one concern I do have is the memory card compatibility. This one has a Samsung 128 gig Evo. Yeah, Evo memory card. I've got another action camera. It's a Yi 4K. Let's see. I've got it in its case. I've not used this case. That's why it's still got the plastic film on it. But I have used the camera. And it's got a Samsung 128 gig Pro video card or memory card in it. So I think what I'm going to do is get a SanDisk Extreme Pro memory card and a 128 gig capacity to use in here. I think it's faster than both of these cards. I think it's like 90 megabit per second write and 95 read or something like that. So anyway, I picked this up at Best Buy. Dick's Sporting Goods actually had this thing for $349.98, and I called up Best Buy, and at their toll-free number, and they matched it. So I bought it right there on the phone and did a pickup at a local Best Buy. So that's a pretty good buy, $350. That's cheaper than what GoPro is actually selling them for right now. I think they're still $399 with a, I think it's a $20 or $50 trade-in credit if you send them a camera. But you know, I don't want to get rid of my GoPro 3 Plus. This thing, you know, works like a damn champ. So I don't want to get rid of it. So now I've got three action cameras. I've not used this Yi a lot. What I have used so far with it, I don't have any complaints. It's been great, but I'm used to the GoPro software, you know? So that's really why I wanted to get another GoPro. You also use PowerDirector and as well. And I really want to get into the video quite a bit with a lot of tools. But for just simple video editing and, you know, compiling video, I just use the GoPro software. Anywho, so we'll see how this thing does. I'm going to strap it to my chest harness maybe this weekend and take it with me when I go fishing and do a test run with it that way and take a look and see how it does and probably change the settings two or three times while I'm out fishing just to see which settings produce the best results and go from there. So hopefully more videos to come that will be captured using my GoPro Hero 6. And that's it. Close.